Yes, good morning, all of you all. So last session, we analyzed the Mendel's monohybrid cross. We got Mendel's monohybrid ratio, 3:1. And we derived two laws out of it. Law of dominance and law of segregation and purity of gametes. So those were two laws which we derived. And then Mendel carried out his dihybrid cross, where he considered two pairs of contrasting characters at the same time and did a dihybrid cross and came out with a law, a third law called as the law of independent assortment. So Mendel's monohybrid cross has given us law of dominance and law of segregation of characters and purity of gametes. That is monohybrid cross. Dihybrid cross, which we will now understand, will make us know Mendel's third law, law of independent assortment. So, chaliye, pehle dihybrid cross karte hai, and then we go into the law of independent assortment. So, what is a dihybrid cross? A cross between two pure homozygous parents in which the inheritance patterns of two pairs of contrasting characters is considered simultaneously is called as a dihybrid cross. So once again, a cross between two pure homozygous parents in which inheritance pattern of two pairs of contrasting characters is considered simultaneously. Say a plant is tall and with red violet flowers is crossed with a plant which is dwarf with white flowers. So how many contrasting characters we are considering at the same time? Height bhi consider kar rahe hai aur color of flower bhi consider kar rahe hai. So that cross between two pure homozygous parents. So pure homozygous, tall is capital T, capital T, and color of flower is capital R, capital R. And crossed with pure double homozygous, dwarf will be small t, and white will be small r. So a cross between two pure homozygous parents in which inheritance pattern of two pairs of contrasting characters are considered simultaneously. Inheritance pattern of two pairs of contrasting characters is considered simultaneously is called as a dihybrid cross. It's a cross between two pure true breeding parents differing in two pairs of contrasting characters. So that's the other way, sir. It's a cross between two pure true breeding parents differing in two pairs of contrasting characters. And what is the dihybrid ratio? The phenotypic ratio of different types of offsprings with different combinations obtained in the F2 generation is called as a dihybrid ratio. And what was Mendel's monohybrid phenotypic ratio? We remember 3:1. What will be Mendel's dihybrid phenotypic ratio? It will be 9:3:3:1. 9:3:3:1 is Mendel's dihybrid phenotypic ratio. So ye yaad rakhna, monohybrid ratio was 3:1 and monohybrid ratio 3:1. Monohybrid phenotypic ratio was 3:1. Dihybrid phenotypic ratio will be 9:3:3:1. तो चलो ये 9:3:3:1 obtain कैसे होता है? Let's see that. Mendel selected a variety of pea plant having yellow and round seeds as female parent and another variety having green and wrinkled seeds as male parent. Yellow and round, female. Green, wrinkled, male. So, yellow color cotyledon is dominant over green. So, female parent kaun sa ho jayega? Yellow is capital Y, and round seed is dominant over wrinkled. So, round will be capital R, and crossed it with a male parent. Male parent mein green and wrinkled. Green is recessive, so small y, and wrinkled, so that is recessive, small r. So, this is the female, this is the male. Ismay se pollen grains are transferred to the stigma of the female plant. And cross-pollination is done. Of course, before that, he obtained pure lines by selfing. He confirmed yellow round is producing yellow round and green wrinkled is producing green wrinkled for 3 generations, like he did for monohybrid. 3 generation tak, yellow round by self-pollination produce yellow round and green wrinkled by self-pollination produce green wrinkled. And then he did an artificial cross. He dusted pollen grains from pure male parent to the stigma of emasculated flower of the female parent. Now, when cross-pollination was done, pollen grains were transferred over stigma. From stigma, pollen grains produce pollen tube, pass through style and into the ovary. Ovary mein there was ovule. Ovule mein pollen tube entered and entered into the egg. Egg was there in the ovule. And male gamete produced by pollen tube, male gamete fused with the egg to form the zygote. And then ovule became seed. Ovule se ban gaya seed. And then ovary went on to become the fruit. So ye fruit pod ban gaya. Jo green color ka pod hum log dekhte hain. Aur uske andar ye seeds ban gaye. Jo matar ke हम लोग घर पे लेके आते हैं पॉड, उसको खोलने के बाद उसमें से सीड्स मिलते हैं. सो ही टुक द सीड्स, फ्रूट पॉड्स वर ऑब्टेन्ड. ही ओपन द पॉड्स एंड कलेक्टेड द सीड्स. ऑल द सीड्स ऑफ द F1 जनरेशन वर येलो एंड राउंड एज वाज एक्सपेक्टेड. ही न्यू कि ये होने वाला है बिकॉज येलो इज डोमिनेंट ओवर ग्रीन एंड राउंड इज डोमिनेंट ओवर रिंकल्ड. सो till the second step, everything went according to Mendel's plan and Mendel's observations. And now, check this. Step 3. He sowed the seeds and raised the plants of the F1 generation. And F1 ke plants sow kiye. And he did self-pollination of the F1 generation. And then pods were obtained and collected seeds of the F2 generation. So, F1 ke seeds collect kiye, unko sow kiya, then unka self-pollination kiya. And after self-pollination, new seeds were obtained of the F2 generation. He collected the seeds of F2 generation. Now, he was expecting 75% yellow round and 25% green wrinkled. 75% yellow round and 25% green wrinkled in a ratio of 3:1, where 3 would be yellow and 1 would be round. And 3 would be, sorry, 1 would be, 3 would be yellow and 1 would be green, and 3 would be round, and 1 would be wrinkled as monohybrid ratios. So in a combination, 3 would be yellow round and one would be green wrinkled. That is what he was wanting. He was maybe expecting. But to his surprise, he found that seeds were of four types. F2 generation seeds showed four different types of phenotypes. There were yellow round, there were yellow wrinkled, there were green round, and there were green wrinkled. So, ये तो अजीब combination मिल गया. He got yellow round 315 of them. He got yellow wrinkled. अरे, original was yellow round and green wrinkled. यहाँ new combination मिला. Yellow wrinkled 108. And then he got green round. Green was supposed to be with wrinkled, but he got a new combination, green round. That also he got 101. And then he got parental type, green wrinkled, 32. So, how many he got green wrinkled? 32. And how many he got green round? 101. So, compared to 32 multiplied by 3 is approximately 101. How many he got green, yellow, wrinkled? 108. So 32 ka approximately 32 multiplied by 3 is 108. And he got 315 yellow round. So 32 multiplied by 9 is approximately 315. So, jab F1 generation sow kiya aur seeds of F2 generation were obtained, which were the four types? Yellow round 315, yellow wrinkled 108, green round 101, green wrinkled 32. So, 315 yellow round, 108 yellow wrinkled, 101 green round, 32 green wrinkled, in an approximate ratio of 9:3:3:1. 9:3:3:1 ka ye ratio mila, and of the four different types, two were parental combination, yellow round and green wrinkled. Yellow round was parental, green wrinkled was parental, but there were two new recombinations. Yellow wrinkled and green round. Yellow wrinkled and green round were new combinations called recombinants. So recombinants. So how many yellow round he got? 9. How many green wrinkled he got? 1. And how many yellow wrinkled new combination? 3. How many green round new combination? 3. So parental combination kitne mile? 9 + 1, 10. Yellow round 9, green wrinkled 1, total 10. Or recombination kitna mila? 3 + 3, that is 6. So we got a ratio of 10 parental and 6 recombinants, new. So, a ratio of 10:6, which is 5:3. So, you got a 10:6 ratio of parental to recombinations, which is 5:3 ratio. Chalo, let's see, how did Mendel get this combination? Mendel had selected parent generation yellow round and green wrinkled, of which yellow round was female and green wrinkled was male. So pollen grains were transferred from green wrinkled to stigma of the female. What will be the phenotype? Yellow round, green wrinkled. What will be the genotype? If you remember, he always starts with pure breed. So it is double homozygous. Capital Y, capital Y, capital R, capital R. And green wrinkled will be small y, small y, small r, small r. Or usme se bana gamete. So कैपिटल वाई कैपिटल वाई कैपिटल आर में से एक ही गैमीट पॉसिबल है, कैपिटल वाई एंड कैपिटल आर, एंड स्मॉल वाई स्मॉल आर से एक ही गैमीट पॉसिबल है स्मॉल वाई एंड स्मॉल आर. तो यू हैव कैपिटल वाई कैपिटल आर, यू हैव स्मॉल वाई स्मॉल आर, ओनली वन टाइप ऑफ गैमीट इज पॉसिबल. कोई भी कॉम्बिनेशन करो आप, तो यू गेट ओनली वन कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ गैमीट पॉसिबल, कैपिटल वाई कैपिटल आर स्मॉल वाई स्मॉल आर. When they are bought in the F1 generation, F1 generation will be genotypically capital Y, capital R, small y, small r. Capital Y, capital Y, capital R, small y, small r. In other words, this can be written as capital Y, small y, capital R, small r. So, which is the genotype, sir? Capital Y, capital R, small r. Capital Y, capital R, small r, of which capital Y is dominant over small y, and capital R is dominant over small r. So, what will be the phenotype? Phenotype will be yellow and round. So, F1 generation may, what is the genotype you got? Capital Y, capital R, small r. Capital Y, capital R, small r. And what is the phenotype you got? Yellow and round. Phenotype you got yellow and round. So, all are yellow and round dihybrids. All are yellow and round dihybrid. Yellow is also hybrid. Round is also hybrid. So it is all are yellow and round dihybrids. Now, beautiful. Now starts the main part. Ye dhyan se sunna. Jab isme se gametes banenge, yellow and round dihybrid will form gametes. Which are the gametes possible? कैपिटल वाई स्मॉल वाई कैपिटल आर स्मॉल आर में से अब कॉम्बिनेशन पॉसिबल है कैपिटल वाई स्मॉल वाई कैपिटल आर स्मॉल आर. और इसमें से गैमीट्स कौन से पॉसिबल बनेंगे? कैपिटल वाई कैपिटल आर एंड कैपिटल वाई स्मॉल आर एंड स्मॉल वाई कैपिटल आर एंड स्मॉल वाई स्मॉल आर. तो वो चार टाइप के गैमीट बन गए, चार टाइप के गैमीट बन गए. कैपिटल वाई कैपिटल आर, कैपिटल कैपिटल, कैपिटल वाई स्मॉल आर, स्मॉल वाई कैपिटल आर, स्मॉल वाई स्मॉल आर. तो दीज आर द मेल गैमीट्स फॉर्म. बाय द वे, दीज आर आल्सो फीमेल गैमीट्स फॉर्म, क्योंकि यहां तो सेल्फ पॉलिनेशन हो रहा है. F1 जनरेशन का सेल्फिंग कर रहे हैं हम लोग. तो सेल्फिंग में वी आर डूइंग ट्रांसफर ऑफ पोलन ग्रेन ऑफ द F1 जनरेशन टू स्टिग्मा ऑफ द F1 जनरेशन ऑफ द सेम फ्लावर. सेल्फ पॉलिनेशन कर रहे हैं. तो यहां चार टाइप के गैमीट्स बनते हैं, मेल एज वेल एज फीमेल, और उनका क्रॉस पॉलिनेशन किया जाता है. सो व्हाट आर द फोर टाइप्स ऑफ गैमीट्स वी गॉट? कैपिटल वाई कैपिटल आर, कैपिटल वाई स्मॉल आर, स्मॉल वाई कैपिटल आर, स्मॉल वाई स्मॉल आर. और ये बन गए मेल गैमीट्स. एंड वही बन गए कैपिटल वाई कैपिटल आर, कैपिटल वाई स्मॉल आर, स्मॉल वाई कैपिटल आर, स्मॉल वाई स्मॉल आर. वो बन गए फीमेल गैमीट्स. So now, जब उनका चेकरबोर्ड किया जाता है, what will you get? You get capital Y, capital R, capital Y, capital R. So you get capital Y, capital Y, capital R, capital R. And you get capital Y, capital R, capital Y, small r. So you get capital Y, capital Y, capital R, small r. And you get capital Y, capital R, small y, capital R. So you get capital Y, small y, capital R, capital R. And you get capital Y, capital R, small y, small r. So you get capital Y, small y, capital R, small r. Similarly, capital Y small r with capital Y capital R. Capital Y small r with capital Y capital R gives you capital Y capital R small r. Similarly, with your capital Y small r, you get capital Y small r small r. Capital Y small r small r. With your, you get Y capital R small r. And with your, you get Y small r small r. Similarly, small y capital R with capital Y capital R, you will get Y capital R. With this combination, you get Y capital R small r. With this combination, you get Y capital R capital R. With this combination, you get Y capital R small r. And small r with capital R gives you Y capital R small r. With this combination, you get Y small r small r. With this combination, you get Y capital R small r. With this combination, you get Y small r small r. तो ये आपको 16 combinations मिले. Of course, the last one or two minutes, I just randomly spoke the combination. Let's see what sense they make. Sir, check this here. ये पूरा diagonal. अब सब लोग सबसे पहले हम इसको numbering करते हैं. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. So you have 16 squares of the Punnett checkerboard. And check this carefully. This entire diagonal is having at least one capital Y and one capital R. One capital Y, one capital R. One capital Y, one capital R. One capital Y, one capital R. Capital Y, 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 capital R. So, at least one capital Y and one capital R is there. So, all these plants will be, because of capital Y, yellow, and because of capital R, round. So, how many plants will be yellow and round? This entire diagonal will be yellow and round. So, the squares 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 9, 10, and 13 will be yellow and round. So, how many are they? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, yani 6 number, 9, 10, 13. In other words, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9 of them are yellow and round. 9 you got yellow and round. So this entire diagonal, you got yellow and round, 9 yellow and round. Then you got square number 6. Check this here. This is capital Y, small r, small r. Capital Y is yellow. But small r, which will be wrinkled. So capital Y is yellow, hai, but small r will become wrinkled. Similarly, square number 8 and square number 14 are capital Y, small r. And usme capital Y will make it yellow, but small r will make it wrinkled. So, square number 6, 8 and 14 are yellow because of capital Y. यहां capital Y, small r, और यहां capital Y, small r. तो एक capital Y है, So that will make it yellow. And those smaller hair will make it wrinkled. So square number 6, 8 and 14 are yellow but wrinkled. So yellow and wrinkled. And check this one. Small y, small y, capital R, small r. So, 11th kaun sa hai? Small y, capital R. Or 12th or 15th kaun sa hai? 12th or 15th are small y, capital R, small r. So because of capital R, it will become round. But because of small y, it will become green. And you got square number 11, 12 and 15, you get green and round. So square number 11, 12 and 15, you get green and round. And green and round. 11, 12 and 15, you get green and round. And square number 16. 16 square, ye last wala is small r. So everything is small, so it will become green and it will become wrinkled. It will become green and it will become wrinkled. So you get green and wrinkled, 16th wala, 1. So, what did we get? We got this diagonal. 9 of them, yellow round. You got 6, 8, and 14. 3 of them, yellow wrinkled. You got 11, 12, and 15. 3 of them. Green and round. And you got 16th one as green and wrinkled. So you got 9 yellow round. You got 3 yellow wrinkled. You got 3 green round. And you got 1 green wrinkled. So you got 9 yellow round. 3 yellow wrinkled, 3 green round, 1 green wrinkled. This was a phenotypic ratio of 9:3:3:1. So what is the phenotypic ratio we got? 9 yellow round, 3 yellow wrinkled, 3 green round, 1 green wrinkled. A phenotypic ratio of 9 yellow, 3 yellow round, 3 yellow wrinkled, 3 green round, 1 green wrinkle. And that was Mendel's phenotypic ratio of his dihybrid cross. Now comes a very interesting logic. What is his genotypic ratio? So what was Mendel's genotypic ratio? Ye interesting, yeah? Check the square. This capital Y, capital R is yellow and round. And capital Y, small r, yellow and wrinkled. Small y, capital R, green and round. Small y, green and wrinkled. But they all are double homozygous. Double homozygous. So once again, you have capital Y, capital R, yellow round, homozygous, double homozygous. Capital Y, small r, yellow wrinkled, homozygous. Capital Y, homozygous, small r, homozygous. small y, capital R, green and round. But green is homozygous, small y, round is also homozygous, capital R, and green and wrinkled, small y, green, small r, wrinkled. So green and wrinkled are also homozygous. So this is homozygous, this is homozygous, this is homozygous, and this is homozygous. So double homozygous, how many do we have? We have 1, 2, 3, 4. This entire diagonal is double homozygous in the ratio of 1:1:1:1. Yellow round, yellow wrinkled, green round, green wrinkled. And it is double homozygous in the ratio of 1:1:1:1. Compare it to double heterozygous. How many double heterozygous you got? So you got capital Y, small y, capital R, small r, capital Y, small y, capital R, small r, capital Y, small y, capital R, small r, capital Y, small y, capital R, small r. So this diagonal is entirely yellow round, but Y is also heterozygous, R is also heterozygous, yellow is also heterozygous, round is also heterozygous, yellow heterozygous, round heterozygous, yellow heterozygous, round heterozygous. So this entire diagonal is yellow and round, both are heterozygous. So it is yellow capital Y small y, R capital R small r. So double heterozygous are 4. Double heterozygous are 4. Double homozygous kitna mila tha hame? 1:1:1:1. Double heterozygous kitna mila? 4. And then you have single homozygous and single heterozygous. Single homozygous and single heterozygous. You get checked this here. Capital Y, capital R, small r. Y is homozygous. R is heterozygous. And fifth one, same. Capital Y, capital R, small r. So Y is homozygous, R is heterozygous. And two are homozygous, heterozygous, yellow and round. Then third and ninth are same. Capital Y, small y, capital R. So yellow is capital Y, small y, heterozygous. But round is capital R, homozygous. So two are a third and ninth are single homozygous, single heterozygous. And then eighth and 14th are capital Y, small r, small r. Capital Y, small r, small r. So again, yellow is heterozygous, but wrinkled is homozygous. So you get capital Y, but small r, and 12th and 15th are small y, capital R, small r, small y, capital R, small r. So again, green is homozygous and round is heterozygous. Small y, green, capital R, round. So green is homozygous, round is heterozygous. So in a ratio of 2:2:2:2, you have single homozygous and single heterozygous. So, what is the exact genotypic ratio? 1, 6, 11, and 16 are single homozygous. 1, 6, 11, and 15 are double homozygous. Homozygous in a ratio of 1:1:1:1. You got yellow round one, yellow wrinkled one, yellow round one, yellow wrinkled one, yellow other green round one, and green wrinkled one in square number 1, 6, 11, and 16. Are double homozygous. Is to double heterozygous. Double heterozygous are 4th, 7th, 10th, and 13th. 4th, 7th, 10th, and 13th are double heterozygous. Capital Y, small y, capital R, small r. 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 Double heterozygous. 4 is 2 single homozygous and single heterozygous. Single homozygous, single heterozygous. Are how many? Single homozygous, single heterozygous, 2nd and 5th are capital Y, capital R, small r. So in a ratio of 2. And then 3rd and 9th. R, capital Y, small y, capital R, capital R. Capital Y, small y, capital R, small r. So again, 2 are single homozygous, single heterozygous. Is 2, 8th and 14th. R, capital Y, small r, small r. Capital Y, small r, small r. So again, 2 are single homozygous, single heterozygous is 2, 12th and 15th. 12th and 15th are small y, capital R, small r, small y, capital R, small r. Are again green and round are single homozygous, single heterozygous. So we got double homozygous in a ratio of 1:1:1:1, double heterozygous, we get a total of 4, and single homozygous and single heterozygous, we get a ratio of 2:2:2:2:2. So, what can the ratio be written as? The ratio can be written as 1:1:1:1:2:2:2:2:2:4. 1:1:1:1 are double homozygous. 2:2:2:2 are double or single homozygous, single heterozygous. 4 are double heterozygous. So that is your genotypic ratio. How is it written though? It is written as 1:2:2. 2:2:4 are yellow round. Yellow round. 2:1:2:2 are yellow wrinkled. is 2-1 is 2-2 or green round is 2-1 is green wrinkle. So 1 is to 2 is to 2 is to 4 is yellow round. Is 2-1 is to 2 is green wrinkled. Is 2-1 is to 2 is green round. Is 2-1 is green wrinkled. So yellow round, yellow wrinkled, green round, green wrinkled in a ratio of 1 is to 2 is to 2 is to 4, yellow round. Is 2-1 is to 2, yellow wrinkled. Is 2-1 is to 2, green round. Is 2-1, green wrinkled. And this is the way the entire phenotypic and genotypic dihybrid ratios are considered. So, I hope you have understood this, all of you. And then Mendel applied the principle of probability statistics. What is probability statistics? Probability of two independent events occurring simultaneously is the product of their individual probability. Do independent event ek saath hone ki probability is the product multiplication of their individual probability. Dihybrid ratio is a product of two monohybrid ratio. Dihybrid ratio is a product of two monohybrid ratio. So, samjho, ek tall and dwarf plant ka crossing kiya. Tall and dwarf. To, uska F2 phenotypic ratio kya aayega? 3:1. Tall and dwarf ka. Aur ek red violet flower और व्हाइट फ्लावर का क्रॉसिंग किया तो उसका F2 रेशियो क्या आएगा 3:1. नाउ सपोज टॉल विथ वायलेट फ्लावर इज क्रॉस्ड विद ड्वार्फ विथ व्हाइट फ्लावर सो व्हाट विल बी द फिनोटाइपिक रेशियो 9:3:3:1. वी हैव जस्ट डन इट दैट इज डायहाइब्रिड. How is that obtained mathematically? 3:1 monohybrid, 3:1 monohybrid ka product is 9:3:3:1. So a dihybrid ratio is the product of two monohybrid ratios. Barabar hai. 3:1 into 3:1 karenge. 3 3s are 9. And 3 1s are 3. And 1 3s are 3. And 1 1s are 1. So simple. 9:3:3:1 is 3:1 into 3:1. As a matter of fact, if you do the monohybrid genotypic ratio, what will be the dihybrid genotypic ratio? You will get product of two monohybrid genotypic ratio. 1:2:1 into 1:2:1. So you will get, what will you get? Ye one. So that is 1:1, 1:2:1. So 1:2:1. Now we consider 2. So that will be 2:4:2. And now we consider 1 with these. Again, you get 1:2:1. Which is coming out to be 1:2:2:4:1:2:1:2:1. So, yeh bhi same aa gaya. You got genotypic ratio also identical. So, monohybrid phenotypic ratio 9:3:3:1. Is product of 3:1 into 3:1. And dihybrid genotypic ratio 1:2:2:4:1:2:1:2:1 is product of 1:2:1 into 1:2:1. Simple. Use probability statistics. So, you remember Mendel had done trihybrid cross, in which he took, say, a tall plant with red violet flower with inflated pod and did its cross-pollination with a dwarf plant with white flower and constricted pods and three contrasting characters. और उनका क्रॉस पॉलिनेशन किया F1 जनरेशन यू विल गेट टॉल विथ वायलेट रेड फ्लावर विथ इन्फ्लेटेड पॉड F2 जनरेशन में क्या मिलेगा अरे बाबा आप अगर ट्राई हाइब्रिड क्रॉस बनाने बनाओ आप पायल हो जाओगे इफ यू डू द चेकरबोर्ड मेथड तो सिंपल प्रोबेबिलिटी स्टैटिस्टिक्स यू यूज इट मेंडल साहब ने तो मेहनत की थी हम लोग कैसे करेंगे सर फॉर अ ट्राइहाइब्रिड क्रॉस व्हाट विल बी द फेनोटाइपिक रेशियो प्रोबेबिलिटी स्टैटिस्टिक्स 3:1 × 3:1 × 3:1 so that is 3:1 × 3:1 is 9:3 × 3:1 × 3:1 9:3 × 3:1 × 3:1 So what will that become? 9 3s are 27 and then we get 9 1s are 9 and you got 3 3s are 9 and you got 3 3s are 9 and you got 1 3s are 3 and you got 3 1s are 3 3 1s are 3 and 1 1s are 1 So, check it again. Simple words. 9 × 3 is 9 × 3 × 3 × 1 × 3 × 1 Do it properly. You will get 27 is to 9 is to 9 is to 9 is to 3 is to 3 is to 3 is to 1 27 is to 9 is to 9 is to 9 is to 3 is to 3 is to 3 is to 1 Ek kaam karna, ghar pe ye try out karna. Take a tall plant with inflated pod and red purple flower. So capital D, capital D, capital R, capital R, capital I, capital I for tall colored flower and inflated and cross it with dwarf white flower and constricted pod. Or isme se gametes banana. And do a checkerboard method and you should get a ratio of 27:9:9:9:3:3:3:1 And usme 27 ka milega. You will get dominant, dominant, dominant. So 27 you will get tall with inflated pod and purple red flower. 9, 9, 9, you will get 2 dominant character, 1 recessive character. 2 dominant character, so you will get, say, tall with purple flower, but constricted pod. Or you may get tall with white flower with inflated pod. Or you may get dwarf with purple flower with inflated pods. So, ek condition recessive ho gayi. Ek mein plant dwarf mila, ek 9 mein plant dwarf mila, ek 9 mein plant white flower mila, aur ek plant mein character aapko constricted pod aa gaya. So, that is 9, 9, 9. Aur 3, 3, 3 mein you get dominant recessive recessive. So, ek dominant hoga, 2 recessive hoge. And yaha 2 recessive hai, 1 dominant hai. Yaha recessive recessive hai, dominant hai. So, 3, 3, 3 ke andar, ek dominant hai, aur 2 recessive character hai. 2 recessive character hai. Aur ek ke andar, you get recessive recessive recessive. So, you get 27 mein all 3 dominant. 9, 9, 9 mein 2 dominant, one recessive. 333 mein, you get two recessive, one dominant. Or one ke andar, you get three recessive. Ye try out karna and get the beautiful dihybrid phenotypic ratio. Ye sab log try karna and let me see how many of you get it actually. Yeah? 27:9:9:9:3:3:3:1. Ye karna hai. In one of the other topics ahead, anyway, I'm going to do tri-hybrid ratio for you. So, ye aapko syllabus mein hai. But you will enjoy this doing it yourself at home. Chalo. So, we have understood Mendel's dihybrid cross and the dihybrid ratio. And now we have Mendel's third law, law of independent assortment, which we just understand now.